I feel like Ed Sullivan. Now, before I bring on the Smashing Pumpkins, they will be in Lawrence, Kansas tomorrow and Denver, Colorado on Wednesday, but tonight they're here. Ladies and gentlemen, the band behind the new CD, Machine of the Machines of God, the Smashing Pumpkins. Two new guests to this extremely uncomfortable furniture we usually don't have. She's the co-host of USA's FarmClub.com and the star of the new movie Beautiful, and her Doritos commercial was the talk of last year's Super Bowl. Would you welcome Miss Allie Landry, please?
Thank you.
Always that somewhat unsettling throaty male. You know, it's threatening in a way, but it means they like you.
Good.
And, of course, Billy Corgan has joined us. And I know you were almost going to wear that, so I'm very glad. Okay, this is our Super Bowl party, or as the kids say, partay. I want to ask this question about the Super Bowl. Bill Parcells, when he won, had a famous quote. He said, winning the Super Bowl is better than sex. And while it may seem an innocuous statement, I think it's very, very threatening.
Sure sounds like Bill.
Bill Parcells, it does. It really does. And I'm sure he meant it. And Dick Vermeil, who's in his 60s tonight, not just tonight, he's been there for a while. Tonight, I don't know what he... maybe his wife will say, you know, yeah, the Super Bowl's way better than sex. But I think any time someone says anything's better than sex, it's trouble. I think things that people sublimate sex for, winning, power, golf, chocolate, shopping, any of that means you're a sick person.
Are you saying that your sex is better than this show?
Uh-oh. Way better.
I think it depends, too, who you're having sex with, right? And I don't think any of these guys would trade, like, you know, sure, they might trade sex for one night, but certainly not.
But if I was having sex with Bill Parcells, I would say winning the Super Bowl was better as well.
Well, you know,
there's exceptions.
There's another coach, I think it was Paul Brown of the Browns, had a Wednesday rule, which meant that he did not allow the players to have sex after Wednesday for a Sunday game, because that old wives' tale, I think it's a wives' tale, that...
It's not.
What?
We have a rule in our band, you can't have sex on a show day.
Oh, come on.
Swear
Why?
To God.
A Women rock and
give you
roll
weak
band?
Legs?
Yeah. Yeah, it messes with your legs and your adrenaline. And unlike you, Bill Maher, I'm giving it all to the people. I'm not saving anything for later. Yeah. I'm making love with everyone.
Yeah.
And Bill Parcells.
Bill Parcells. You tour for months at a time, though, don't you? I mean, you're just on... Well, that's a lot of...
He didn't say about after the show.
Oh, sure.
Is that right?
Before, Pete, I think these players are really... First of all, we need to understand, really superstitious. And once they get this in their heads, it's sort of like a mental thing, you know?
I think it is a mental thing, because I don't believe that at all. I think...
I'd like to know how the coach checks up on the team.
Right, right, exactly. You know the wives and the girlfriends are...
Phillips, you
know,
I hear you in there! Phillips! No, coach, no, I'm studying the playbook, that's all.
Well, you played. What did, Mark, what did you, when you played, did you feel
scoop.
That it sapped your
there
energy?
There was no Wednesday rule, I know that. You know,
yeah.
Friday night, they'd lock you in the hotel before the game, but that was really about a team thing and meetings and all that. But you know, I don't even think that was policed. I mean, you have to only be talking about football here, right?
Well, any sport.
No, boxing, famous wrestling.
Wrestling?
Yeah.
Wrestling.
I've heard that. Well, you know, not WWF.
Let's limit this just to sports.
Okay, not that okay. one. I didn't mean... Okay, fine.
No, you're right. Wrestling, they take
yeah.
it... No, I,
not that kind I of wrestling.
But really, I mean, you must have some scientific evidence. You must have had sex some days before a game and some not. What was the better result?
Tell us.
We all want to know, Mark.
All ears.
It's such a non-issue. I mean, it's a complete non-issue in my mind. I mean, I number one, I don't think it can ever be policed. No, coach, not me. Did not. You know, I mean...
No.
I mean, are your band members telling the truth? I'm just asking. Maybe.
Well, you're implying that we're not having sex with each other.
Not at all.
Hey, shades of Fleetwood Mac, my friend. Let's bring that back, huh? All right, we got to take another break. We can't go over tonight. We're live. We'll be right back. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the Smashing Pumpkins.
another visit with Margaret Cho in Atlanta.
Okay. All right, now we got a good chunk of time here on the panel. I definitely wanted to get to this issue. This, to me, was the big football story of last year. Of course, you all heard about the tragedy at Texas A&M. They built that tower of logs, which they've done for about 90 years for no good reason. It fell down. Get this. Now the school is spending $1 million to study why it fell. Apparently, Isaac Newton was not an Aggie. The Texas A&M president said, we have an obligation to the families to provide good information about what caused it to fall. Why? Why not just don't build it again?
Because it's tradition.
It's tradition.
Yeah.
Yeah. What is that?
90 years, like you said.
But tradition means what?
Well, has it fallen before? That's my question.
It did fall once in 1994. Miraculously, no one was hurt. But even if it didn't, why do something just because you always did it? Is that a good reason to do something?
Yeah, when you go to college, that's the whole fun of it. You have tradition. People look forward to this. They want to do it. Let them do it. But not if it hurts someone. I understand that. I think $1 million is a bit steep. Sure, investigate. I'm sure the parents of the deceased would appreciate that. But, you know, it's a bunch of kids who got drunk and got carried away and used really bad judgment.
Yeah.
And you want to carry that tradition on?
No, I said not carry that tradition on. The tradition of building the bonfire itself.
The bonfire.
I think that they built it too big. I think they were jumping all over the place and going crazy. It's an accident. Accidents do happen.
But why build a bonfire?
Because it's college and people do things in college. You can't explain it. There's no explanation. I'm sure everybody's done things in school. You know, you just do it because it's fun and you're kids.
Why can't they? I did things in college.
Yeah.
Like throwing up on the sidewalk outside of a pizza parlor.
It's tradition, isn't it? Isn't it, Bill?
But I don't want to continue that tradition.
She's going out in a tour of Fiddler on the Roof. It's tradition of it. Now, my people believe that nothing good has ever come from a big burning fire. Burning fire, bad for my people.
Yes, you're right. There is something very Nuremberg about a bonfire.
Yeah, is the football team all charged up the next day going, they built a fire for us last night.
Yeah.
You see that sucker burn?
Football team's not there. They're in the hotel. The
team's not there. That's right.
Yeah.
These are all the people that didn't make the team going, let's build a fire.
It's disturbing that people talk about the tragedy that, you know, they say that the great tradition was tarnished. But the tragedy, to me, is people doing things for no other reason.
I'm not saying panel, but it seems so obvious that if you respect what happened, you would basically never do it again. That would be the true way to honor the people that died.
Right.
This idea of kind of foraging on for the big game.
Yeah.
I think it's exactly that kind of sentiment that creates a situation where you build a dangerous bonfire because the big game is so important. But we all know the big game is really not that important and certainly not worth people's lives. So.
And certainly.
Do you still believe that they should spend the millions of dollars in the investigation?
It's been millions.
If they're doing it to find out what actually happened for, you know, criminal reasons or litigious reasons, which is probably true, that makes sense. If they're doing it to justify building
criminal, not even Oliver Stone could find a conspiracy here.
They put
things on top of each other and they fell. It's ironic because Texas A&M stands for Agriculture and Mechanical Engineering. And this was a tradition that was passed on only orally. Nobody ever wrote a blueprint.
I think Bill is right. The million-buck investment is probably a hedge against the lawsuit. Well, you know, so if they can say, well, what happened was they apparently were drunk blotto, and we're going to put $1 million into that, and
it's throwing, of course,
they're protecting themselves.
They're protecting
when the lawyers come. They will come, of course they'll come.
Right.
But, you know, we had traditions in this country like women couldn't vote, African Americans sat in the back of the bus. Traditions don't mean anything.
But they do. I wish that was true. I wish tradition didn't mean it, or at least people would examine why a tradition is a tradition. And so, you know, Thanksgiving is a tradition, but, you know, it has a meaning. We're sort of sitting...
It signifies us killing all the Indians.
Exactly.
And taking over their land.
All right, bad example.
No-win situation here.
Bad example. All right, I want to thank all my guests, Jason Alexander of Margaret Cho, Billy Corgan and the Smashing Pumpkins, Shannon Elizabeth, Mark Harmon, Allie Landry, Rick Schroeder, and the Smashing Pumpkins. There they are again. Join us Monday when my guests will be Christopher Reed, Bob Larson, Sonny P.O.D., and Marriott Ross, and Mom and the other folks who watch the show and never have rock and roll. I promise we won't have rock and roll for a while, but we were glad to have them today.